good vibes. Welcome to yet another fun, exciting, inspiring, awesome, vibrant, joy-inducing at lahat-lahat na sa bagong season ng The Tim Yak Show. Isn't it great that we're already on our 7th season? Diba? Dahil yan, sa patuloy niyong pagsuporta mga ka-good vibes, kaya naman makakaasa kayong lagi-lagi kaming mamimigay ng good vibes para sa mga tulad mo, tulad ko, at tulad nating lahat na merong
insomnia!
Kaya naman para sa makarami, karanat simula ng ating nightly updates. For tonight, the Aldab people continues dito sa The Tim Yap Show. Ang pag-uusapan naman natin ngayong gabi ang mga supporting characters ng sikat na kalye serya ng 8 Bulaga. Sabi nga ng mga fans, kung wala sila, hindi magiging super fun ang inaabangan at nag-iisang kalye serya sa tanghalian. So we better get to it, pero babala! Tsak sasakit ang chin nyo sa kakatawa! First on our list, and definitely not the least, siya na nga ang sumasalo sa lahat ng pambabash ng mga fans dahil siya ang hadlang sa tuwing pagkikita ni Alden at Layadag. Siyempre, kilala natin siyang lahat na si Lola ni Dora. When she was introduced, ipinakilala siya bilang ang mayamang si Doña ni Dora Esperanza Zobelayala, Feuda the Explorer, na Lola ni Doctora the Explorer. And huwag kayong basta-basta umusga. Lola ni Dora graduated from the Universidad Central de Madrid in 1878 at ang grade daw niya, sobresaliente. Edi wow!
Sabi na nga ba, sa totoong nakabaling niya si Hitler, Charlie Chaplin at Albert Einstein eh. Baka naman pati si Emilio Aguilar naligaw sa kanya.
Well, next up, ang unang kakambal ni Lola ni Dora na siyang dahilan kung bakit delayed lumabas si Lola ni Dora sa tiyan ng nanay niya, si Lola Tidora. Actually, hindi nga mukhang Lola itong si Tidora dahil napakinis at free from wrinkles pa rin ang kanyang mukha. Parang hindi nga nagkakalayo ng edad sa kanyang mga bodyguard na sina Bernardo. Aside from that, kakampi din si Lola Tidora ng Aldab Nation sa pag-iibig ng Alden at Yaya Dab.
Kung siya meron Bernardo, tapos si Lola ni Dora meron namang Rogelio, at si Tidora meron namang Cuando, ako rin meron bodyguard.
Sino?
And this is Facundo.
Naku, nagulit ka si Dora. Kumpletuin na natin ang triplets at heto na ang next character, si Lola Tinidora. At first, it was revealed na siya raw ang tunay na ina ni Yaya Dab. Pero sa kanyang pagdating, ang kanyang pasabog, hindi siya ang nanay ni Yaya Dab. Kundi ang isa pa pala sa kanilang kapatid. Ay, si Lola Tinidora ang pinaka-liberated daw sa kanilang magkakapatid. Kaya naman, laging siya ang may pinaka-maikling skirt sa kanilang lahat. At kung si Rosa naman ang naging kapatid din nila, panigurado, siya naman ay ang pinakamaikli. Period. From the Lolas, puntaan naman natin ang mga karibal ng Aldab. At una na nga dyan ang super yamang si Frankie Arenoli. Frankie was born and raised in Italy at nakipagkasundo nga siya kay Lola ni Dora na pakakasalan niya si Yaya Dab para makuha niya ang mana from his parents. Yun nga lang, twice na heartbroken si Frankie dahil hindi natuloy at walang visa ang pagpapakasal niya kay Yaya. Ang tanong ngayon, babalik pa kaya siya sa eksena para maghiganti?
Hindi na po, kasi asawa ko na siya ngayon at mayaman na kami. I'm so happy to finally be Arenoli.
Ang panghinaman ng apelidong yan? Lastly, ang babaeng taga New York na minsang sumubok na kunin si Alden kay Yaya Dab. Si Da Riz, or Da for short. Sumugod si Da Riz dito sa bansa nang malamang may sakit si Lola ni Dora, pero peke lang pala ito at nagpapanggap lang si Lola. Kaya bumalik din agad sa States si Da Riz.
Kamusta kaya nga siya ngayon? Nakakamis ang blondie niyang buhok at sexy niyang katawan. I love you much, Da Riz.
Sino sa tingin niyo inyo ang magiging fan addition sa ating kalisere. Tweet or Instagram me your suggestions at Official Tim Yap. Sige, at sabihin natin sa mga friends natin sa Eat Bulaga. Yap, next guy na Yaya Dub at Alden, super sikat din at isa rin sensation sa design world ang ating guest for tonight. We're crossing over from pop culture to lifestyle and design when the Tim Yap Show returns. Ikaw, nakasakit ba? Welcome back to the Tim Yap Show. Kasama natin for tonight, an interior designer with his own furniture line and the editor of the best-selling home magazine in the Philippines, My Home Magazine, and now a TV host himself, Nix Alanon.
Hi, Tim.
Hello, Nixie.
Hello, Tim.
Okay, Nix Alanon pala.
Thanks, Rosa.
Hello, hey, Nixie.
Very good.
How are you?
Good, good, good.
Alam ba nung isang araw pinaparod kita, you know, you were talking about homes, and congratulations on your TV show.
Thank you.
O, kamusta naman yun, di ba? You've been doing a lot of things from designing people's homes to designing furniture with your furniture line, Phoenix Home, and then now TV. Paano mo siya napagsasabay-sabay?
You know, a lot of people ask me how I'm able, you know, how I balance in TV, yung magazine, my design business, and the furniture line. And
ang sagot niya, hindi niya binabatas.
No, I always tell them, you know, I don't naman accept anything na hindi ko kayang, you know, tapusin or anything. Oh. It's just that before siguro kung meron kang, you know, in a day, meron kang downtime, you know,
yes,
or you can actually, like, you know, do something else. Ngayon medyo it's all about work, which is okay because I get my free time naman when we travel. You know naman how much
yes,
we love traveling.
Oh, super daming travels. So, how is it like paano yung ano mo, yung design process mo, Nixie? When you get a project, okay, how do you envision a space? Kasi, di ba, sobrang daming tao ngayon ang nagde-decorate ng mga sarili lang space from their apartments, condos, to their homes. Alam mo, give them design tips.
Okay.
How to start?
Okay. With me, when I do my interior styling, it's always about, you know, knowing the space first. So, you have to understand how big your space is, the theme that you want, because it's hard na minsan bili ka na ng bili and you end up acquiring so many things na hindi mo naman kailangan.
Naku, alam ko yan, oh.
And then you have to, you know, stay focused on the look that you want. Because it's so easy na, you know, while you're shopping.
And to get carried away.
To get carried away, nakita kang ganito. And then you have to realize that you have to stay with your vision. Because otherwise, yun nga, malilito ka na and everything. I guess that's it. And most importantly, you should always have fun. It's all about, you know, having fun and liking things that you like. Once yeah, you start getting influenced by other things na hindi mo naman gusto, then that's gonna come out completely different.
Nagiging chop suey.
Nagiging chop suey, yes.
Oh. For people who are decorating their spaces, is it best to get the services of an interior designer or best to rely on their own instincts? Best to go with magazines and follow pegs?
When it comes to interior styling, of course, it would have to still depend on your personal style. Mm. You know, there's so many, like, things that you can get pegs from ngayon. Like, there's Pinterest.
Oh.
There's also
My Home Magazine.
Of course, I was gonna say My Home Magazine.
You
know,
Pinterest.
No, of course, that's the highlight. But of course, My Home Magazine is one of the, you know, and the best, I would say, na source of inspiration. Because it's something that you can get locally. Instead of yes, something you see online na hindi mo naman talaga magagaya because you don't know where to get it from and all that. So it's very achievable.
You know, you've been doing your interior design practice for quite some time now. What made you, tackle a publication, be behind the scenes for My Home Magazine?
I would say that, I've been getting offers for quite some time now. Even as
Regal Viva,
Regal Viva, ganyan,
diba?
Seiko. But it really, for me, it was really timing when I started with My Home.
Yeah.
Okay, so I had a lot of offers before. And I guess when My Home came into the picture, I was really ready for it already. I just felt that the timing was right. Marami na rin akong, you know, experience before. May mga features na rin ako before. Because in the beginning, I was thinking, I don't want to be, you know, just tied up with one magazine. Yes. But I guess now I've also reached a point in my career, being, you know, doing this for almost 8 years, 9 years now.
Pang-mature roles ka na.
Pang-mature roles na ako. So I guess also it's time to sort of like give back, you know, from the things that I know and share it with other people as well.
Ayun.
So it's all next about inspiring
naman,
other people.
Parent roles ka naman next time. Oh. Next time. So, also like, so, now that you are an editor-in-chief and a TV host, what are the new things that you're learning with regards to your craft?
One of the things, to be honest, that I'm really happy about, and I didn't know that I would be so interested in, is the business side of it. I am so interested in, you know, knowing about who the target audience is, what covers people like. Mm-hmm. For me, there's a science into it.
Yes.
That I never really, I mean, I would think of before, but I guess it's different also when you think of aesthetics and you think of your readership.
Oh, kasi diba before, as a reader, we would all only be concerned with content. Ay maganda, ay hindi maganda.
Yes.
Ay pangit yung pag-layout, ay pangit ang kulay.
Or the things you personally like.
Yes, exactly.
So you have to remove, I have to remove myself sometimes from the picture.
Some personal biases.
Yes, yes. And see it, in a, you know, with the eyes of the readers.
Ano ba ang gusto ng readers? What do people like in terms of home design? What sells? What is current? Ano yung mga mabenta ngayon?
Okay. Of course, it has to be something that is, you know, it's always, there's a lot of like magazines right now, and you always have to be offering them something new. You always have to be, you know, there's a lot of trends, and you always have to be, you know, up there in terms of giving them the latest inspiration, latest places of where to get things. Of course, andyan din yung mga home features where they can actually look at while they're doing their own home. So they get inspired with that. So, yun.
Quality covers, ano ba? Are people more attracted to colorful homes or design edgy, futuristic? Anong mga type ng tao?
Of course, what sells immediately when you see it on a newsstand with something that has color. I mean, I think
pop.
But I think generally in anything, if you line them up all together, you would automatically notice the, you know, the, something that has a pop of color, as you said. But I guess also you have to think about, you know, the content as well, because you want to keep your readership. It's not all about just one-time basa. You want to maintain them and keep them, you know, watching out and getting your magazine every month.
Yeah, because you know, just like with Raho, it's a long-term relationship. Diba? With your view, with your readers.
Yes.
Diba? Ganun yun talaga, diba? Oh. Diba? Alam mo, ata ka, babakit. Ayun. Alam mo, okay, we will talk about more about Nick Alanon's design work, how he started, and all other things about his life because you only see him in magazines, you see him on Instagram and other online sources, but now we're actually getting to talk to him. That's the mga yan. Here's Nick Alanon. Let's see next show with her. Welcome back to the Tinap Show. Kasama pa natin, Nick Alanon, editor of My Home Magazine. O, diba? Okay, Nick, how did you start designing? You know, and it's really good that in this generation, diba, parami ng parami, people are deciding to take on design career paths. Diba? Before, it was very limited. Diba?
Yes.
Ngayon, in all areas of design, you know, from interior to fashion to styling to photography, napakarami ng subcategories.
Mm-hmm.
How did you start?
How did I start? Of course, you know, I started out when I was young.
Tito Nicks or nga naman.
No, honestly, when I was young, I thought I was going to be a fashion designer.
Okay.
So that was one of the things, as in growing
up. I will be Rahul Avril.
Okay, so anyway, I would, you know, be designing clothes. So everyone, including, you know, in the family, thought that I was going to be a fashion designer.
Oh, wow, okay. So, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so, and then I guess when, you know, when I was maturing, I realized there's other parang facets of design that
avenues,
I
can...
Avenues, oh. Yes, and avenues of design that I can, you know, parang pwede kong puntahan pa. So then I realized I like putting things together. I would buy things like kunwari mga plates and set them up and then, you know, show everybody na I did this, ganyan. So it started with that. And then I realized, why don't I try doing interior design? So I did, you know, a little of interior design school. And then I started doing my projects already. And then sunod-sunod na.
Oh, one thing led to the other. And yes. Then now you have Phoenix Home.
Yes.
Yeah, you make a lot of beautiful things from chairs, tables. I've seen homes and projects, bars, clubs that you've designed, and yeah, job well done.
Thank you.
What if, ano ba yun? Kasi kuwari, di ba? Pag fashion designers, you can tell if it's a Raho, if it's a Joey Samson, Ivar. When it comes to interior designers, is it the same? Does it follow?
Yes. Mas padalas that you have to be in the industry. Because I know already when it's done by a certain
interior trabaho designer. Trabaho ni ganito to. Trabaho
yes,
ni ganito
alam
yan.
Ko na. Colors pa lang, accessories pa lang that they use, I would already know. Whether it be here or abroad. Mm. So yes, I guess it's the same thing also with fashion.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So what's the advice that you can give to you know, young people who want to be like you, who to embark on a design career?
You have to just you know stay and harness the talent, whatever that is. So, you know, do a lot of research and you know inspiration as well, and you know try to learn many styles as much as you can, because I would say that you know when you're doing what I do, you have to be client driven. When I say that, you have to know you know when your client says, okay, the look is Mediterranean.
Uh-huh.
So you have to, you know, change your mindset and put it to Mediterranean. Kahit hindi mo personal style yun.
Oh, oh, oh.
When your client says modern, then you do modern.
Same page kayo ganun.
Yes. I guess that's how you grow and yeah. That's how you become successful. Also.
And how you because successful collaborations result from that.
Yeah.
What is the signature design of Nyx?
I would have to say my style is very, you know, eclectic. Mm-hmm. Eclectic, when you think of eclectic, sometimes it can be very extreme. Pwedeng like something really modern with something really old. But mine would have to be eclectic, but my end goal is to be, you know, to achieve timeless interiors. Because nowadays, you know, times are, you know, parang, you know, it's really going on fast. So, dapat parang when you look at it 5 years from now, 10 years from now, hindi siya masyado dated.
Mukha pa rin siyang bago.
Mukha pa rin siyang bago. Because you never really parang, you know, got stuck with a certain look that will get, you know, that will stay there,
yes.
You know, so remarkably.
Advice to homemakers right now on how to beautify, how to reinvigorate their homes.
Advice to them, I guess I would have to go back to what I said earlier.
And not having to spend so much.
Okay, sige. Not, there's so many places that you can go to for, you know, cheap finds. There's so many, let's say, department store stores around. There's a thing called high-low, so you can do that also. High-low meaning you get something high, which is something expensive, I guess, a splurge. It could be a chair. It could be something that will be very visible in an area. And you mix it with something low. So you go to, you know, like all these mga... Tawa ka. All these department stores and ganyan, and mga small items. And you mix them together.
So, alam ko mag-mention ka na.
Hindi. Inisip ko rin yun.
Hindi kasi talaga naman eh. Kasi again, it depends on the budget, di ba? Pero what we want to say also to our viewers is that you know it's hindi siya
it need not to be expensive.
It need not be expensive.
Need not be expensive. You can have a very expensive taste, but if you know where to source, that's very
alam
important.
Alam mo, di ba marami pa nga sa mga vintage markets, sa mga
yes.
sa may Bangkal, sa Makati, diba?
Yes, Evangelista. Ano pa yung isa sa Bidangwa, that area?
Oo. Tsaka naman yung parang yung rule ngayon is that there are no rules. Just
yes.
like in fashion,
yes.
as with interior design, di ba? Meron ka makikita ng mga upuan na mga galing sa mga lumang auditorium or sa eskwelahan mixed with pieces that are supa nila, di ba? Yes. Ganun.
So yun yung sasabi at eclectic style. So you know, mix something old with a new, something expensive with this, something from a different time era to something...
Ibang place sa Pilipinas, so souvenir shop, halo-halo, nasa pagkatamang timpla ng halo-halo. Okay, now it's time to play some games. Nakabahan
na ako.
Oh, so, basta question answer lang to. Oh, parang beauty pageant lang yan. Okay, music lover or book lover?
Music lover.
Hot or cold?
Hot.
Lollipop or hipon?
Lollipop.
Hugs or kisses?
Kisses.
Matamis o maanghang?
Maanghang.
Smooth and slow or fast and wild?
Fast and wild.
Top or bottom?
Or.
Ay, no. Versa. Hey, moreno o mestizo?
Mestizo.
Chinito or puppy eyes?
Puppy eyes.
Hairy or smooth?
Hairy.
Nakatayo o nakaupo?
Nakatayo at nakaupo? Pwede ba yun?
Pwede nga naman. Pwede. Up and down, di ba? Mabasa-basa or mamula-mula?
Mamula-mula.
Ayun. Malaki o magaling?
Magaling.
Oh, malaki and magaling pwede naman.
Malaki and magaling.
Sa loob o sa labas?
Sa loob at sa labas.
Ayun, ayun. In and out, in and out. Nacy, thank you so much.
Thanks so much also.
You know, again, for being such a good sport and for coming here and sharing us your thoughts. Dahil napakaraming tao ngayon ang they're building their homes, they're building, you know, a good life stems from a good home, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, again, please invite them to watch your show and to purchase your magazine and from online to everything that you're doing, pati na Phoenix Home.
Okay. So
I'm a proud customer, by the way.
Yes.
Of Phoenix Home.
Yeah. So we did a couple of things for Tim also.
Yes.
So please grab a copy of our 15th year anniversary. It's our 15th year anniversary, actually, for my home. So it's a very good time that I'm here to celebrate their 15th year, being the longest running magazine also in the Philippines. And then we have our book. It's called My Home Inspiring in Theaters, out in mga bookstores and newsstands. What else? We have My Home Today also. Airing also in GMA News TV. Phoenix Home is my furniture line.
Yun.
And my firm, FTA Design, for your interior styling needs.
There you go. Alam mo, dahan-dahan. Tell your needs, you just have to start and pursue your craft. Take it one day at a time. Always pursue inspiration. Travel as much as you can. And then you can do everything and have an empire just like Nix Alanon. From design to products, to television, to magazine, lahat ginagawa niya.
Still building.
Diba? Because it is possible. Thank you so much to Marriott Hotel Manila for being the home of the Tim Yap Show Season 7. And again, Nix, thank you so much for giving us that inspiration and keep on beautifying homes with all the things that you're doing. Ayan, talagang naka-good vibes. Like kong sinasabi, dapat laging good vibes para laging good night. Sama sa Nix Alanon, you are watching the Tim Yap Show. Good night.
Good night.